Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna.
Tasmei Shri Guru. Krishna Parna Sindhu Dinabandhu Jalapati Gopi Sarupa कौन सा प्रेम हम लोग का वहाँ प्रेम हम लोग को प्रेरणा है सिलो महाराज जी श्री गुंथा गोविंद से हम लोग श्रवण किया ये राधा प्रेम कृष्ण का कोई प्रेम नहीं ये राधा की प्रेम है इसलिए ये राधा सर्व विषय में उत्तर करता उनका महिमा दिखाया गया राधा जी कोई कोई पल्पों में वर्षा में आविर्भूत हुआ है जैसे विश्वभानु खो रहा है वर्षा में वहीं पर विश्वभानु महाराज स्नान करने के लिए है कुंड में और उसमें पद 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 में तो हटरी है और हंसते हैं और उसको देख करके मुग्ध होकर के विश्वभर महाराज उसको लाल बुद्धि में लेके किसी का देवी को दिया है और कोई कल्पों में इधर रावल में श्रीमती राधा जी को जन्म हुआ है सब सब तो ठीक है विशेष विशेष कल्पों में कल्पों के अंदर इसको दर्शाया गया है एक कल्प समान मैंने ब्रह्मा का एक दिन तो ब्रह्मा का एक दिन अर्थात 30,66,20,000 वर्ष एक कल्प है इसलिए एक एक कल्प भेदे विशेष विशेष लीला का वर्णन किया है ये हम लोग देखा एक कल्प बात विचार करेंगे और दूसरा कल्प का विचार नहीं करेंगे तो हमको हमारे सिद्धांतों में थोड़ा सा सस्पेक्ट होगा इसलिए विभिन्न पुराण का उदाहरण लेकर के हम लोग कल्प भेद में इन लोग को जो लीला चरित कथा हम श्रवण करेंगे तब तो साबित हो जाएगा इसलिए हम लोग राधा जी को प्रार्थना का राधा कृपा कटाक्ष में जो बताया है कि राधा जी का कृपा राधा भजन यदि मति नहीं भला कृष्ण भजन तब अकारण चला आप रहित सुरस नहीं मानी राधा विरहित तो माधव नहीं मानी इसलिए इसमें बताया है कि राधा भजन व्यतिरिक के कृष्ण का भजन नहीं होगा इसलिए राधा रानी को अनुगत तो हम लोग पढ़ना चाहिए कृष्ण तो पुरुष बहु है लीला आस्वादन करने के लिए तो पुरुष का हृदय थोड़ा कठिन होता है और राधा रानी स्वयं अलादिनी स्वरूपिणी शक्ति तत्व है स्त्री रूपा इसलिए हिंदू के हृदय सरल होता है इसलिए राधा रानी जितना कृपा का उदाहरण है सब शक्ति तत्व का ही है कृष्ण का इतना ही नहीं है इसलिए हम लोग राधा रानी माध्यम से राधा रानी कृपा लाभ करने के लिए प्रचेष्टा करेंगे ये प्रचेष्टा एकमात्र सफल होगा जो अनुभवशील व्यक्ति जो है जो वैष्णवगण उनको अनुगत में एवं उनको मुखर बिंदु से हरिकथा श्रवण करेंगे राधा तत्व श्रवण करेंगे तब तो राधा रानी को कृपा हम लोग को बिना गुरु वैष्णव का कृपा और राधा रानी का कृपा नहीं होगा इसलिए मैं द्रुपद पद्म तथा अभिन्न द्रुपद पद्म शिक्षण द्रुपद पद्म सब वैष्णव चरणे मेरा प्रार्थना है आप लोग कृपा करें जिससे मैं उनकी कृपा लाभ करने को चाहूँ बनता
Thank you. ये बातें जहाँ तो बोल रही थी
Because He had some little desire. I want to do bhajan, but he is something forest. So this desire, so one kind of fall, but in lateral position. It's called Murchit Kasai. Nidhut Kasai means fall, there is no lateral, fall completely overshadowed. The second example is Sukhdev Goswami. Third one, Prapta Parshad Bhagavad Deha. The second stage of Narad Rishi, being an associate of Supreme Mother God and eternally all over universes. So why is Bhakta Bhagavad you can know about Grantha Bhagavad? Grantha Bhagavad also two types. Chaitanya Bhagavad, Srimad Bhagavad. Especially in Dhammapalli, under the guidance of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, none can advance in Krishna consciousness. So we have to know about Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu and have to accept him as a guru. Like Das Goswami has told, Sachisunum Nandisara Patisati Guru Varam. Guru Varam means Shastra Guru. If you want to enter in Krishna realm, have to consider Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, Guru Varam means Shastra Guru. So you have to know about Chaitanya Bhagavat and Srimad Bhagavat both. Unless until you are not knowing about Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, not getting much of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, none can advance in Krishna consciousness, what to say about entering Krishna's realm. So by this way, if you want to advance, then you have to come to Rupa Goswami's Upadesamritam. Guru was discussing in Volgograd in Russia, that Pacha Bhagavan Mahasar Tadavivan in this world, this is for householder, means householder practice first, who will be renounced, either Brahmachari or Sannyasi. They must have to be extremely qualified about this. Every year we have seen and we have heard from Mr. Lotus Leaf. Every year our Guru Vargas, they fixed growth after the Soda process. So why should Rupa Goswami Pad start watching on what is the goal here? And what the process? So, Sarvam Abhiman Prithivin Etan Veganya Vishayita Dhira Sarvam Abhiman Prithivin Sashishya. So Vishayita Dhira, then Dhir Purush. What do you mean? Can control the whole world. How? What kind of Dhirpurus? Big Ritam Vajrapati Siddhancha Vishnu. Saukham Mitanu Sriya Rathavarna Yajya Bhakti Param Bhagavati Pratibhakthakama Siddhirogam Apar Aswa Panit Tachiniya Dhira. Big Ritam Vajrapati Siddhancha Vishnu. Big Ritam, in special way, who is playing with Vajrapati, with so many Vajrapati. Why not only one Vajrapati? Bahukanta Vinane Rasarullah. Without so many kantas, there is no greatness of God. So Dajavadubi, Vidancha Vishnu. So who will hear this? Sardhan Nito, with full faith. After that, moreover, Sardhan Nito Anusmiya have to listen regularly and under guidance. Now what should we do? Not only Anusmiya, Atha Parma Yajya. After listening, he have to describe to others. Then, Vidya will go away. So, who will hear continuously and under guidance and describe the Shalom, he will be him. So, what is ultimate goal or aim of this Upadesamritam? The Rupa Goswami is telling, he, Vishwaita Dhira. What kind of thief? Who is always receiving past times of divine karma and describe others. For that this process, Bhakta Begum and Sakode Begum. Here is the process and this is the goal. So, knowing this, now I have to know, if you enter in Krishna realm to bhajan, what the aim we have told us before, Asai Dasya Vishohan Jaya, then you have to know the relationship first. So, what is the relation between ourselves and Srimati Radhika Purani? What is the relation between ourselves and Krishna? What is the relation between Sri Radhakrishna, Srimati Radhakrishna and Sri Krishna have to know all these things. What is the relation with Radhakrishna? And what is the relation with Krishna? We have no direct relation with Krishna. Our direct relation is Srimati Radhakrishna. That's what Sri has told. Madhisa Nathapati, Kaja Vipina Chandran, Kaja Vameshwari, Kam Nathapati, Kavasura Sakhi, Dev Tudolitam, Visakanshik Chalitvarana Gurute, Piyasaro, मनीषा नाथते विष्णुमुद्रा नाकरानी सीता सामिनी डायरेक्ट लेसन विथ हर बट नॉट डायरेक्ट लेसन विथ नंदनंदन हु इज शी इज द बिलवेड ऑफ आवर सामिनी जी दिस दुर्गत रिलेशन सो नोइंग दिस यू हैव टू एडवांस इन कृष्णा कॉन्शियसनेस सो our director is Radhika, that is our Swaminiji. What she wants, we have to do that. And in which pastimes, the greatness of Radhika, the son, we have to know that also. So, Arjuna asked to Krishna, it's mentioned in Adi Purana, again, the Kaviraj Goswami quoted in Chaitanya Charitamrita, that which pastime is best, and who I saw? Krishna told, Shanti yatrapi me prajya, lilastata manohara, nahi jane smrite rase, marame kitne sambhave. I have so many pastimes. And prajya, prakrishta ichya prajya, all are highly worshipped by sadhakas. Still, even his sakha lila, asala lila, or madhurya lila, all are very attractive. We have seen how in the pastimes, Sakha pastimes is so nice. Patsala pastimes like politic training or Dhammanam is so nice. When with the Vyasaya or the pastime with Gopi is so nice. So all are very attractive. But Krishna is telling, Lilasata Manohara, Nahi Jane Smrite Rase Manome Kitrishan Bhave. But I don't know how my mind became upset or became too much controlled or I became bewildered only in Ras pastimes. Why so? Because Ras pastime, in Ras pastime, the supremacy of Radhika has shown everywhere. If Radhika is there, then Ras pastime is there. If Radhika is separate from Ras dance, then Krishna will not be there. As you have yesterday in Brahmaple. So, when Mahaprabhu, Dayamandi described to Mahaprabhu that Sri Krishna Chandra took away Radhi Radha Thakurani from the prayer of gopis, then where is the greatness of Srimad Radhika? Where we have shown it? And only in those past times, the greatness of Radhika has been shown that Anaya Radhika Unam Bhagavan Hari Nishtara Yanno Vihara Govinda Pritota Manayantraha. The Egerspati gopis, they are and are the Sapaksha, Vipaksha, Tatastha, Sripaksha. All are searching for Krishna. But Sapaksha, the Sapati Spati of Radha Thakurani, they are searching Srimati Radhika and Krishna Bhav. When they found the blueprint of Srimati Radhika, they became extremely happy. Oh, our Sakhi is with Krishna Chandra. Our Sakhi is not alone anywhere else. And Krishna Chandra is going alone. So Sakhi is there. But Vipaksha, they never saw Radhika's lotus feet. They never seen the footprint. They do not understand who is she or whose footprint is this. So they remark, Anaya Radhika Unam Bhagavan Hari Nishtara Yanno Vihaya Govinda Vitoja Manayantraha. There must be this Gopi has heart body. So, Bhagavan Hari took him in solitary place. And when Mahaprabhu asked that it seems that Krishna becomes so fearful for all gopis, so he took her, like kidnapper, not in front of everyone. Then Ramananda Rai quoted another slogan from Gita Govinda, Kamsayati Samsara Vasanabhatta Srimkhalam Radha Mataya Hridaye Tattajabaya Sundari. Even in last dance, Krishna wants to show the greatness of Srimati Radha Thakurani, so give up all gopis. In presence of, in front of all gopis, Krishna took Radha Thakurani and disappeared from last dance. By this way, the greatness of Radhika has been established. And why Gaudiya Vaishnavas want to be inclined towards Radhika? If we want Krishna playing, but Krishna prem is the Ashajatya prem for towards Krishna, like Sri Bhagavad Gita Maharaj told, not Krishna prem, but Ashajatya prem. Why so? Because Srila Bhaktivinoda Thakur has told, Radhika Dasi Yadi Hoi Abhiman, Sikha Milay Tava Gurukula Kan. If we have ego or pride, proud that we are made servant of Srimati Radhakarani, Krishna is very easily possible for us. So, our Gaudiya Vaishnavas are telling, Bhakti na Krishna Charani na Karomi Charti, Radha Padam Bhaja Raja Panasana Sena, Tasa Digam Charnipata Vishesa Vedka, Doiva Janamai Gurasati Dasi Bhutti. Bhakti na Krishna Charani na Karomi Charti, you don't want to pray the lotus feet of Krishna. And don't want to any devotion for lotus feet of Krishna. And it's Hamadri, we are low. Why you become so popular? What is the cause? Then our Guru was replying, Radha Padam Bhuja Rajasa Raja Kanasa Sena. I have the small particle of Srimati Radhika Krishna. By this I am so bold, so I am not caring for Krishna. Vrajapana Tosha Diganta Nipata Vishisa Vedta Dovibadayam Kvarishya Dasi Buddhi. If sometime she thought that she is my maid servant, then Krishna bound to control by me, so I don't care for Krishna. I always care for Srimati Radhika Krishna. So our Guru has told, Adhemi kārnu bhagatat tadayata vācha yāche nipatta bhūvi kandavato dhubhatārdi asya prasāda mabhutasta janasya tikta gandharvi ke yagane ganarām idhei. Here also prayer for Srimati Radhakarani, not for Krishna. And if we pray for Radhakarani and not Krishna, then what will you answer? Then our Guru replied, don't worry. Why not? Because Krishna never did alone. He always controlled by Srimati Radhika. How come? Radha prayati vipinam vipinam prayati Radha nikunja sadani sajatatra nittam Radha sukhe sukham kuketta dukhe cha dukhi Krishna kadati kholu tishpati na satantra. Whenever Srimati Radhika enter in any vipin, any forest, Krishna enter there. If Radhika is nikunja sadam, then Krishna enter there. If Radhika is happy, Krishna happy. If Radhika is unhappy, Krishna unhappy. So never be alone. So Krishna always controlled by Srimati Radhika. Now time has been passed. So all are looking towards the lotus. We want to listen from Guru lotus. So I want to finish here. And other time, when we get time, let me explain other things. Hare Krishna. Parcha Bhagavadu Bhakti Vidhavan Vidhaya Vajra Vidhavan Vidhavan.
इन्होंने राधिका जी के तत्व के संबंध में बहुत कुछ जयदेव जी के गोविंद का भी उदाहरण दिया कि चोरी करके ले गए तब तो राधा जी की महिमा नहीं हुई, सबके सामने किसी की अपेक्षा ना करके ले जाए तो राधिका जी की महिमा है। और भी बहुत से उदाहरण भक्तिशाल महाराज जी बेटर यू टू सी टाइम टू टाइम स्पीक एंड वी हैव सम टाइम 15 मिनट यू टू स्पीक So, when you request the Shri Gurudev, we're going to glorify Srimati Radhika. But our words are not actually sufficient to glorify Srimati Radhika because her glorification affects Krishna. And only great personalities like Sri Jayadev Goswami and our Goswamis, they can actually write beautiful stavan and stuti glorifying Srimati Radhika. So our words are like those of little broken children, broken words of children. But for the pleasure of Srila Gurudev, we'll try to speak something. So Srimati Radharani, she appeared in Babel, and her father, she's known as Vrishabhanu Nandini. because Vishwamanand Maharaj, he was going to take his bath early in the morning, and he saw a beautiful thousand-petaled golden lotus flower. And in the middle of that lotus flower was a beautiful baby girl, kicking her legs and moving her arms. And he was completely captivated. So he took this little girl home with him. And they were very overjoyed to have such a blessing. Actually, Brahma said in a voice that this is the Swarupa Shakti, Kundalini Shakti of Bhagavan himself has appeared. And Rishabhanu Maharaj took her home. Narada Muni, in the meantime, he already knew about the appearance of Krishna. So, because he is Vaishnava, he knows that wherever there is Parashaktiman, Parashakti cannot be far away, it must also be coming. So, he knew that Krishna had appeared, but now he wanted to find, oh, where is his Parashakti? So he was going around Braj, chanting, and going from door to door to find if there was any appearance of some baby girl. And when he came to the home of Vrishabhanu Maharaj, he asked, oh, do you have a new baby here? And Vrishabhanu Maharaj says, yes. And he brought his one-year-old boy, Sridham. And Narada said, no, a newer baby. So he said, well, actually, yes, I have a new baby girl. And Narada became very excited. He said, oh, may I please, have you done any sanskar for her, for a birth ceremony or blessings? No, not yet. Oh, please, you allow me to do this. So Vrishabhanu Maharaj was very pleased to have such a great exalted sadhu to come and do this ceremony for Radhika. So he brought her into Radhika's room, and then he went to go get all the paraphernalia for such puja, sanskar. Now Narada was in ecstasy, looking at the beautiful little girl, and he closed his eyes, and he began to offer prayers. Suddenly, he heard a very pragalba voice. Hey, Narada, open your eyes and look upon your Ishtadev, David. So, who is speaking in such a bold voice to Narada? This is Lalita Sakhi. So Narada opened his eyes, and there was Srimati Radhika in her Navakishori form. Not to just entering the period between childhood and adulthood, most beautiful age. Srila Bhaktivinoda Thakur has described that Krishna, being absolute truth, he's unlimited, infinite, and he's also infinitesimal. But we cannot have a relationship with the infinite or the infinitesimal. So because he's absolute, Krishna also has a very charming medium form. If you go out and look at the universe, which is limited, but it's so vast, it's very difficult to feel a relationship with the universe. What to speak of? The unlimited expanse of Krishna, or his infinitesimal form as Paramatma, and smaller than the smallest. Very difficult to feel a relationship there, or to have a relationship. But Krishna is absolute, therefore he's also a beautiful medium size that we can relate with and have a beautiful relationship with. So that form of the absolute, which is medium size, Srila Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Thakur said, the all accommodating, charming medium size. It's accommodating both the infinite and the infinitesimal, and you can see it before your eyes. So now he got to see the all-accommodating, charming form of the Parashakti, Radhika herself, in that just beautiful age between childhood and adulthood. So when Narada saw Srimati Radhika in that form, accompanied by her eight Kayavyuha Shaktis, the eight principal Sakis, he immediately went into ecstasy, fell on the ground, rolling, weeping, and crying. Just at that moment, Vrishabhanu Maharaj came back in with a paraphernalia for doing the puja. And instantly all the Sakis disappeared, and Srimati Radhika became just a little baby girl again in her crib. And Vrishabhanu was looking, oh my goodness, what happened to Narada Muni? He's rolling on the ground. Did something happen? Are you all right? And Narada composed himself quickly and said, oh, everything is all right. And so he got this very beautiful sporty, a private darshan of Srimati Radhika. So wherever there is Krishna, Radhika will not be very far away. And Krishna's love, Krishna's sweetness and beauty affects Radhika so much. And Krishna wanted to know, is there any love like Radhika's anywhere in this universe? So we all know how he saw her playing by Chitja, how she was, even though sitting on his lap, she was weeping in separation from him. And yet when he was not there, they were feeling comforted by embracing Tamaltri, seeing Krishna everywhere. So he went to Mathura, and so many Mathura Ramanis, and he went to Dwarkadish, and then he even arranged to try and enjoy and see if there was any love like Radhika's in all the different species of life. And when he rescued the 16,000 princesses and queens and girls who were from all parts of the universe that Narakasura had kidnapped. In this way, he could taste all different moods of Radhika and her different expansions as these different girls and forms. But never, never he could find anywhere in the whole universe anyone whose love was like Radhika's. So he tried himself and he failed. So therefore, he realized, I have to now, to understand Radhika's love, I will have to assume her moods or bhavs. And therefore, Krishna came as Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu to fully understand her love. And we're so very, very fortunate in this particular Kali Yuga. Srila Gurudev gave astounding information last year in Berlin. He explained, because the question may arise, in the Nitya Lila, in Dwarka Dham, Krishna is very satisfied. He is completely satisfied with the service of Rukmini and Satyabhama and all his queens. But during his Lila, in Prakat Lila, in this manifestation, in this Kali Yuga, when he goes to Mathura, he's weeping in separation from the gopis. So Gurudev said, we will have to reconcile this because Rupa Goswami has described that Krishna, Radhika, they never step a foot outside of Vrindavan. So who is this Krishna who is weeping in Mathura, who when he goes to Dwarka, in spite of having 16,108 wives, is still crying at night and wetting his pillow, calling on Radhika's name. So who is that Dwarkadish? So Gurudev explained, these are special manifestations of Rajendranandana Krishna. This is not Vasudeva Krishna and Dwarka or Mathuresh Dwarka and Krishna and Dwarka and in Mathura. This is a special manifestation called Vyogi Krishna. And that Radhika, who is in Vrindavan, V for Viparlamba, separation move. Yoga means union. So Krishna is feeling union and separation, Vyogi. And Radharani is also feeling Vyogini, union and separation. And again, when they are meeting in Kurukshetra, who is that Krishna? And who is that Radha if they have not ever left Vrindavan? This is Samyogi Krishna and Samyogini Radhika. And there they are having meeting, but they are feeling separation from Vrindavan Dham. So Gurudev explained all these beautiful truths about Radha Tattva. And on there's one last thing that Gurudev said last year in Berlin. And he said, I think that most devotees will not be able to understand this subject, and I'm certainly one of those. But even if I continually speak about it, only a high class of devotees can realize something, and yet I am explaining it. I don't know why I am telling you this. This is my bad habit. I want to forget management and other external activities. I want to immerse myself and weep bitterly like the gopis do for Krishna. I want to serve Srimati Radhika and be very happy to control Krishna. I want that she will order me, be at the door of the kunj and don't let Krishna come in. These pastimes are in my heart. So in Vedic tradition, on someone's birthday, they give a gift. Now in the Western culture, people give gifts to the person having the birthday. So also we gave gifts to Srimati Radhika from all over Mathura yesterday. Gifts were coming by the wonderful arrangement of Gurudev to celebrate her appearance day. But also, I think Shrimati Radhika that on this her celebration of her appearance that she will fulfill Gurudev's desire very soon, please. Hare Krishna.
Now Sam Rani will just take picture with me. Not more than that.
I offer my unlimited obeisances in the dust of the lotus feet of my Paramarani Sama, Diksha Guru Paramarani, Nitya Leela Purushta, Om Vishnu Pad, as those who sit the Sri Srimad Shri Bhakti Vedanta Swami Prabhupada, and the same unlimited obeisances in the dust of the lotus feet of my Paramaraja Sama, Diksha Guru Paramarani, Om Vishnu Pad, as those who sit the Sri Srimad Shri Bhakti Vedanta Narayan Gosai Maharaj. To all of our Guru Varga and all the assembled devotees. As Srila Gurudev has said in the last few nights, and as the speakers have so nicely said, Srimati Radhika is the manifestation of the highest love, Madanatya Mahabhava. Her emotions are the reality, and all emotions in this material world of love, hate, envy, desire, lamentation, happiness, of all perverted reflections of the real emotions of Srimati Radhika. So, Radha Tattva is Prem Tattva. And Prem Tattva has two divisions. One is separation and one is unity. Sometimes Srila Gurudev explains that separation is higher, and sometimes he explains because in separation, one forgets everything external and only becomes absorbed in inner moods. But we've also heard him say that meaning is higher, and we'll discuss both of those. So one feature of separation, Srila Gurudev explains everywhere he goes in the West, when he speaks about the five bhaktas, the highest among whom is Uddhav, and then Uddhav's glorification of Srimati Radhika. Krishna sent Uddhav to Vrindavan to go to the school of the principle of love, Srimati Radhika, to go to her university where her expansions, Lalita and Vishakha, are the headmasters. So Krishna sent Buddha so that he would learn the meaning of the 2.5 letters, Prema, in the same place where Krishna learned about love. As was quoted yesterday or the day before, Radharani is asking Vrindadevi, what is Krishna doing? Oh, he's learning love from his dancing master. That is your image, which he sees everywhere. Just like the leaves learn from their dancing master, the breeze, the wind, and uncontrollably they fly in the tune of their dancing master. So Krishna is uncontrollably lost, taking shelter of the love of Srimati Radhika. So Krishna is sending Uddhava to learn in that same university so that Uddhava could experience some of that love and come back to Dwarka and relieve Krishna's feelings of separation by his new understanding. So when Uddhava went there, he met the gopis, and under Radharani's inspiration, he was given a test to enter into her university of love. He failed that test miserably because, as Gurudev said, one required 85% and he only got 25%. He was questioned by her inspiration in his examination. That is, please tell us, oh Shyam, you're Shyam like Krishna, but you're not that Shyam. You're wearing his pitambara, you're wearing his garland, and you're also Shyam, but you're not that Shyam. You're coming from that Shyam. Please tell us something about our Shyam. We have a question about love. That is, we see that the birds take shelter of a forest, and they get so many benefits from the forest. But when that forest goes up ablaze, The birds don't remember the forest at all and they run away without caring at all. Somebody goes to Gurukula and they learn so much from the teacher. But once they get the diploma, they completely forget about that Gurukula and their teachers. No more relationship. And some beggar is going door to door, begging some alms and giving some instructions for the welfare of the person in the house. As soon as he gets the alms, he forgets the person, no more instructions, and he goes away. So under Radharani's inspiration, the gopis are asking Buddha, how is it that our love was so strong? We gave up everything. We gave up our chastity to husband. We gave up our consideration of abuse of society. Krishna apparently also gave up everything to meet with us. And then all of a sudden, he disappeared, never to come back again. How is it that such a love, which is selfless, somehow or other appears to have broken? And what did Buddha do? Gurudev said he scratched his head. He couldn't answer at all, and therefore he couldn't be admitted. The gopis brought him to their Priyasati Radhika so that he could witness her love and separation. But somebody was already there witnessing her love and separation, and that is Sri Krishna. As Madhav Maharaj just mentioned, in order to make Radharani happy, Krishna left Vrindavan and went to Mathura, thinking that something is lost in meaning. Every time Radharani is feeling meaning for me, like in Train Sarobara, then she thinks that I'm separated from her, and she weeps and beats her chest, thinking that I'm gone and I'll never return. But when I'm not there, then she chastises the cloud. Not, oh cloud, but, oh Krishna, I know what you did. I don't want any relationship with you anymore. Or when she sees a tamal tree, she may embrace it, thinking that it's me. But something is lost in meaning, and everything is gained in separation. So this person who was thinking like that, he thought, well, I'll make Radharani and the gopis happy by leaving Vrindavan. But what happened? It got worse for them, and it got worse for him. He felt more separation, and they felt more separation. So Uddhav now is witnessing this love and separation of Srimati Radhika. But somebody had already come to witness it, and that is a bumblebee. But who is this bumblebee? Srila Gurudev says this bumblebee might very well be Sri Krishna, who, always desiring to be astounded by the love in meeting and love in separation of Srimati Radhika, came to be astounded in the form of that bee. So Radhika told that bee, oh bee, don't touch my feet. I know why you've come. You've come to make a compromise. You want me to make a compromise with that other black. You're black, and your mustaches are, I know they're filled with kumkum, and that's how they got their orange color. How? Because you've come, just come from Mathura. Everything that Radharani sees is in her, as Srila Gurudev explained yesterday, in her very, very highest Madanati Mahabhava, which no one but her can understand. So she's now Miss Mohanbhav, which is included in the Madanati Mahabhava. Now she's in Mohanati Mahabhava. And she's saying, I know why, because she's seeing everything in relation to her Madhurya Bhav. She's not seeing Krishna in relation to any Aishwarya Bhav, though she says, I heard from Purnamasi that Krishna has so many incarnations. But I know that in Krishna's past lives he was the same black that he is now. And he sent his black messenger. I know that your mustaches are orange from Kumkum. Why? Because you've come from Mathura and you've been on the garland of Krishna after he's embraced one of his queens, also trying to get rid of Hermann. Krishna spends the whole day in Dwarka going from one to another, or in Mathura.